Welcome to Highway 89, Utah's most scenic musical byway. I'm Peggy Woodruff, and joining me in the studio this hour are the musicians of the Verdade Quartet, violinists Rachel Osler and Mayu Greenalch, cellist Quinn Boyack, and violist Brian Liu. All four are students in the Brigham Young University School of Music, and all four are also members of BYU's Chamber and Philharmonic Orchestras. These are busy people. The Verdade Quartet was recently made the Honors String Quartet of BYU, and the ensemble took grand prize at the 2012 Utah Chamber Music Competition. Today, they'll be performing music of Janacek, Prokofiev, and Webern, and we'll also be visiting with each of them a little bit between the pieces. But first, let's let their music do the talking. We'll hear the first movement of String Quartet No. 1 by Czech composer Leoš Janacek. Thank you. That was music of Leos Janacek. We heard the first movement of String Quartet No. 1. You're listening to Highway 89 on Classical 89 and BYU Radio. I'm Peggy Woodruff. Brian Liu is a two-time winner of BYU's concerto competition, winning in 2011 and 2013 with performances of viola concertos by Walton and Bartok. He's graduating now and will soon be heading off to Indiana University to pursue his master's degree. Brian, congratulations on your acceptance there.
Thank you.
I looked it up. It looks like a great program.
Yes, it does. I'm excited by the prospect of studying with some great teachers and great faculty.
Brian, you started on your instrument at the age of 5, which isn't really unusual as far as beginning instruments is concerned, but you actually started on the viola at age 5.
That's
How
right.
is that possible? Do they make violas for 5-year-olds?
I don't know if they do, but
when How did that happen? What's the story behind that?
Well, my mom, she's a native of Hong Kong, and when she grew up, she didn't have a lot of music in her home, and she always saw different street musicians, and she decided at a young age that she would have her future family all be involved in music. So when she came to the United States and had a family, she devoted her life to making sure her children played string instruments. And so my older siblings all learned the violin, and I had another older sibling that played the cello, and I grew up listening to them practice the violin, and I always thought it was very screechy and high, and I didn't enjoy it very much. And so when it was my turn to learn an instrument, I told my mom that I didn't want to learn the violin. And she's like, well, you could do the viola. And I was like, well, what's the viola? And she said, well, it's kind of like the violin, but it's lower, and so it sounds better. And so I said, okay. And she used our old violins, and then she put a C string on it. So that's how I started.
Wonderful. You performed in China with the BYU Philharmonic. Your mother must have been thrilled about that. Had you ever been there before?
I had visited China two previous times to visit family. And so coming back to perform was a great experience.
Well, wonderful. We would love to hear some more music from the four of you. Brian, best of luck in your graduate studies. Music of Sergei Prokofiev is next. We're going to hear the first movement of his String Quartet No. 1 in B minor. This piece was commissioned by the Library of Congress in 1930. Prokofiev didn't usually compose chamber music, but he rose to the occasion this time. Here's the Verdade Quartet. Thank you. That was the first movement of String Quartet No. 1 by Sergei Prokofiev. I'm Peggy Woodruff, and today we have the musicians of the Verdade Quartet in our studio. Rachel Osler is a senior from Miami, Florida, who's had the opportunity to perform in the United States, Argentina, Brazil, Paris, and China. Welcome, Rachel.
Thank you, Peggy.
What took you to such far-flung places as that?
Well, I went with the chamber orchestra to China, for one. Paris, I went to last summer, and I had the opportunity to attend a summer program there for music. Argentina and Brazil, I just went there, and friends of my family put on concerts, and I played in them.
You're an international performer already. Congratulations. I'm curious. The name of this ensemble is Verdade, which is the Portuguese word for truth. How did the name come about?
Well, when we formed our quartet, we started thinking about names because we didn't want to just be Honors Quartet. We started out as the Honorary Honors Quartet, actually, last year. And we were thinking about the School of Music's motto, seeking truth in great music. And so we wanted it to be something along the lines of that. I thought of Veritas, actually, in Latin. And Brian, who of course speaks Portuguese, suggested Verdade. So we liked it and we stuck with it.
It's good. It fits you. You're from Miami, and I understand that you don't do all your music making indoors. I don't think I would either in Miami, such beautiful place. Where do you do your music making?
Well, I mean, Miami has great weather all the time. So whenever I go home, pretty much like Christmas break or summer break, my dad has this like idea for me to be a street musician. So he tells me, like, oh, let's go play on the marina. Like, we'll just take you. And he, like, set up a Twitter account for me for people to follow. And I just sometimes play on the beach and stuff. But I don't know. I've done a few concerts, like, on the bay because my teacher in Florida lived on the bay, actually. So
I see.
He would set up concerts there all the time.
If you practice outdoors, I would love to be your neighbor. Would love to hear you. Rachel, it's good to visit with you. While you rejoin the group, I'll tell our listeners that next we will continue with Prokofiev's String Quartet No. 1 by hearing the second movement performed by the Verdade Quartet. The second movement of a string quartet is usually the slow movement, but Prokofiev may surprise us.
Thank you.
We're listening to music of Sergei Prokofiev. That was the second movement of his string quartet No. 1 in B minor. You're tuned in to Highway 89. I'm Peggy Woodruff, and today I'm visiting with the musicians of the Verdade Quartet, the honors string quartet of Brigham Young University. Their cellist is Quinn Boyack. Even before coming to BYU, he had some pretty remarkable music-making experiences. He sat as principal cellist for 3 years on the New Mexico All-State Symphony Orchestra. He also had the opportunity to travel to Brazil and Australia for performances with the Albuquerque Youth Symphony. Quinn, I don't know many youth symphonies who can travel abroad. That must have been very memorable.
Yeah, it was a remarkable experience. The Albuquerque Youth Symphony has been an amazing program for my family. We've had members of our family in it for about 15 years now, starting with my older brother, and they do an annual tour every 3 years, so I got the opportunity to go to Brazil and then Australia.
Wonderful. So now you're studying at BYU, and you're a member of this wonderful quartet. I know that all four of you are members of at least 3 ensembles. How many hours do you have together a week to rehearse?
We have been rehearsing for 4 hours a week pretty consistently this semester. We have 1 hour with our coach, Monty Belknap, who is one of the violin professors here at BYU.
What other involvement does he have with the quartet? Does he choose music for you? Who chooses your repertoire?
We chose our music on our own. We listened to the music and thought it was really awesome, and so that's how we decided it.
I'm loving it. It's wonderful stuff. Your quartet has decided to memorize some of your pieces, and that sounds rather daunting. These are long pieces. What are the advantages of having them memorized?
Well, we, for our performances, we memorized the movement of the Janacek and the Webern, which you'll hear in a few minutes. And
they're not easy pieces either.
It's true. They're pretty challenging and quite exposed for each part. But we feel in the performance the effect of having the music memorized and completely involved with each other and in our own part is a really powerful effect, especially for string quartet.
I notice as you play a lot of interplay, a lot of looking at each other, a lot of interplay.
Yeah.
Have you ever drawn a blank when you were playing a memorized piece?
Yes. On our last performance, I had the moving note of a dissonance right before a resolution, and I forgot it. But that's okay. It happens.
Life goes on, doesn't it?
Yep.
I wish you all the best in your music studies, Quinn. Thank you for being here. Well, we mustn't leave Prokofiev hanging with just 2 movements. The Verdade Quartet will complete his string quartet No. 1 as they perform the 3rd movement. Prokofiev evidently loved this finale as he made 2 other transcriptions of it, one for string orchestra and one for piano. It's distinctive in that this is the slow movement.
Thank you.
That was the final movement of String Quartet No. 1 by Sergei Prokofiev. You're listening to Highway 89 with the Verdade Quartet. I'm Peggy Woodruff. Violinist Mayu Greenalch spent this last year as concertmaster of the BYU Philharmonic and playing solos in performances of Mahler's Third Symphony, Tchaikovsky's Sleeping Beauty, and Stravinsky's Rite of Spring. Mayu, you also soloed with the Utah Symphony. When was that?
Utah Valley Symphony, actually.
Excuse me.
That'd be great if it was Utah Symphony.
It would be. Utah Valley Symphony recently?
No, that was when I was 16.
Wow. Good job. In addition to this radio performance, today is also your senior recital. Is that right?
Oh, that's right. Yep.
Why do you look so calm?
I have 10 hours before I have to play.
Okay.
So I still have time.
Most undergraduates don't have any assignment or project that parallels what a senior recital is. So help us to understand a little bit of what goes into it. How long have you been thinking and planning for this?
The beginning of this semester, usually I think people prepare for the recitals longer than that, but my teacher made me start all new repertoire at the beginning of January. So I kind of researched on my own and figured out what I wanted to play.
And is it's your responsibility then to establish the repertoire for your senior recital, or do they make suggestions?
Your teacher can have a say. I think it's what you want to play, so it's mainly your decision.
Uh-huh. I'm curious about the actual performance. Do you have someone there grading you or preparing a formal critique?
I believe for the senior recital, you have to have at least 2 members of the faculty there, and it's pass or fail, so.
But you'll have cheerers honors, won't you? You'll have family there or
friends? I sure hope
friends.
So.
Bringing you flowers, hopefully? Hint.
I really hope so.
Well, Mayo, as they say in the theater, break a leg, but don't break a string, please.
Thanks so much.
You'll be heading off to Montana after this year. What is there
That's
for you?
Right. Well, I nanny this family that has 3 children, and all of them play the violin and piano. So they were, I guess, lucky to have me because I kind of play mom and I can teach them. So
that will be an adventure. Good luck with that.
Yeah, thank you.
As Mayu heads back to her violin, the Verdade piece has one more piece to play. I hope I pronounce it right. It's Langsamer Satz by Austrian composer Anton Webern. The title is translated simply as slow movement, and it was one of his earliest works. I understand that it was inspired by a walk in the Austrian woods, which he took with his cousin, Wilhelmina, with whom he was in love, and I guess he later married her.
Thank you.
We've been listening to music of Anton Webern, a tender piece called Langsamer Satz. And that concludes another edition of Highway 89. This hour we've heard from the Verdade Quartet with violinists Rachel Osler and Mayu Greenalch, cellist Quinn Boyack, and violist Brian Liu. All of them are students in the BYU School of Music and members of BYU's chamber and philharmonic orchestras. The Verdade Quartet took grand prize at the 2012 Utah Chamber Music Competition and was recently made the Honors String Quartet of BYU. The ensemble performs standard classical repertoire as well as 20th century repertoire and popular music. To each of our musicians, thank you for being here, and thank you for your preparation and for a great performance. I wish you every success going forward in all your endeavors. Hopefully we'll hear more about you in the future. In the meantime, we're always glad to hear from you, our listeners. We welcome your comments and questions. To contact us, simply email us at highway89@byu.edu. Highway 89 is a production of BYU Broadcasting in Provo, Utah. The recording engineer is Mark Waite, and the show's producer is Jackie Tateishi. I'm Peggy Woodruff. Thanks for listening.